So first of all, why I bought this lens. I wanted this lens for a very long time because I want to have a lens primarily for video and I want a fixed aperture. So this lens is an f4 aperture and it's an f4 on the whole zoom range. So every focal range, it is f4 basically. And I really want to try out an S Pro lens because they're certified by Leica. And I thought a company like Leica doesn't connect their brand name on a product that they don't believe in. So I thought this must be a pretty hefty lens. I did a lot of research on the internet on this lens and I couldn't find a lot of videos about this lens. I think mainly because it is an F4 lens and most of the people are kind of scared of an F4 lens because they think it is not enough. I think an F4 on a full frame camera is pretty enough to do your work. I'm shooting this on the Lumix S5 Mark II and it has a dual native ISO of 640 and 4000. And if you boost your ISO to 4000, then you have plenty enough light for most situations in my use case. So an F4 is enough for me. I don't need an F2.8 or something like that. So next I want to talk about the build quality of the lens. If I compare it to the kit lens, the 20-60mm, I think this is a much higher quality lens if you look at the materials that they used. And I think you can expect it from a lens that is almost, what is it, 3-4 times the price of the kit lens. But they used plastic and metal, but they used a very high quality plastic. So I think the build quality is pretty good for this lens. So if you take a closer look at the lens, there are no physical buttons on the lens. So we don't have a manual focus to autofocus switch like on the kit lens and the other lenses from Lumix. But we have this focus clutch. So if you pull back the focus clutch, you are in manual focus. And if you pull it back upwards, then the lens is in autofocus. And the great thing about this is your camera will automatically switch to manual focus if you pull back the focus ring. So that's, I think, a very handy feature. Sometimes in my use case, I want to manual focus, so I pull back the focus clutch and I am immediately in manual focus. So I think that is a great option on this lens. So next I want to talk about where do I think this lens is for. I think this is a great lens for professionals or semi-professionals. I think the price is very hefty for a hobbyist, but if you make some money with photography or videography, I think this is a lens you need in your kit. This lens is great for landscapes, great for interiors, so real estate, and I think this is a great lens for video work. I have done 2 professional video gigs with this lens and I am really impressed by the usability of the lens but also the image quality you get out of this lens. If I compare it to the kit lens, this lens definitely gives you much better image quality compared to the kit lens. I think the colors are more vibrant and more popping off the screen if you compare it to the kit lens, and I think it's worth the extra price that you pay if you compare it to a similar kind of lens. So are there any downsides on this lens? Of course there are. I think it's a very heavy price that you have to pay for this lens. I know it's an S Pro lens and it's from the Pro lineup, and they used very expensive materials on this lens. You can feel it on the lens, but the new price of this lens is somewhere around 1600 euros on the time of this recording. But as you saw in the intro, I've bought it for 950, and I think 950 is a great deal for this lens. So if you want to buy this lens, definitely check out the second-hand market, but watch out for scammers. Do your research, and I prefer buying it by a store who sells second-hand products, like I did on MPB. So next I want to talk about my experience using this lens. I have it for a month now, and I did some professional work with it because I want to give you guys a real experience and not a quick unboxing and slam the lens on the camera and said, oh, it's a great lens. I want to have some work done with this lens before I give you my opinion on this lens. So here is my honest opinion on this lens. So I think it is a great lens. It is a great image quality you're getting on this lens. And I think for the price that they ask for it new, it's a little bit too much money to pay. So I think if you really want this lens, go search on the secondhand market. I really like the 16-35 focal range. And I use this lens mainly for my video work. But like I said, if you are a real estate shooter, you're definitely gonna love this lens. The 60mm on the full frame is really wide, and I can see that you're using this lens for real estate. Then the build quality, you can definitely feel that it is a premium lens. And they have well thought of this lens, and I really like the focus clutch, that the pull mechanism. Some downside of this lens is maybe the size and the weight. It is a pretty heavy lens, and the size is not so small for an f4 lens. I think there are brands that are making smaller lenses on an f4, but if you're looking at the footage produced by this lens, I think the size increase doesn't really matter, because I really like the image quality coming out of this lens. So that's it for this video, guys. If you have any questions about this lens, leave it in the comments and I will answer your question. And if you like Lumix content, consider subscribing, because I'm a Lumix shooter and I mostly produce content about Lumix cameras. So thanks for watching, and I see you in the next one.